Have you ever tried time blocking in Notion? While I usually use a calendar app, I've actually found a solution to have decently aesthetic looking time blocking in Notion. Let's talk about that. So here's an example of what I have created for an example work week for time blocking. And I usually get up early in the morning and have a time block where I'd work on Rise Productive from 4:30 to 7:30, followed by a workout, then work, lunch, work, and then the cycle repeats. So with that in mind, how did I get all these days to be in a row? And what properties am I using to make all this look like this? So I'm gonna make a slash database inline and then change this to a board view where the card size is small and the card preview is the cover image. So then from there, we're gonna have to utilize a few different formulas and properties. So first, what you're gonna wanna do is make a select property. And I'm gonna call this life bucket. So this is just more of an indicator one where I'm gonna have work, Rise Productive, growth, and life. And I'm gonna color coordinate that. And then from there, we're gonna need a date property. Anytime will suffice, but I'm gonna put date. I'm gonna need a property for day of the week. And what that property is gonna be is a format date, then the name of the date property, and then a comma, and then parentheses DDDD, and then another quote, and then parentheses it off. And this essentially is showing if I were to put something right here, that would be Monday, and it's formatting this date for it to be a Monday. Now I'm gonna add an extra formula here, which I'll talk about later, but this is a this week question mark formula. And then I'm gonna basically take this and go format date and then the date property, comma, parent quote week with a W there. And then we're doing a Boolean here. That's basically saying, is this a date that is this week or not this week? And make sure to put a parentheses before everything there. So this is actually showing that this Monday date was this week. And then two other properties I'm gonna make are time of day. So we can have morning, afternoon, evening. Then the last property is going to be a text property that is just the literal time. Then from here, in order to get that page to look more like this, we need to change some things with the board view. So first we need to go to the three dots here, then go to the grouping section, and we need to change this to a group by day of the week. So the issue with this sort of thing is that one, you're gonna have to go and press manual sort and make sure the text is by exact. And in order for this to show every single day of the week, what you're gonna need to do is duplicate the first one you made, delete any ones that don't have the day of the week and hide this. And then you're gonna have to make seven of these and then basically pick a day of each week. And after you cycle through all of these, you're going to then have to manually sort them by whatever it is, whether it's Sunday through Saturday for you, or you want to do it in a different way. So now I can drag here to have my Sunday. And then now I have an actual thing that showcases the right week here. But then how did I get the rest of that to show up? Then what I need to do is go to properties. And what I want it to show is obviously the name, because hiding it would be a little odd, but we can have the name, and then we would have the time text property that I made, and then we would sort this by the date and make sure it's ascending. So what this is gonna do, since I have a date property, is essentially order it top down from a time perspective. So the beginning of the day would show first. So if I were to take this block and then I can add a cover image, let's say it's a Rise Productive work session, add a little icon for a little phone or something, make the cover red, and then I could have it say, we really want it to be more like 4:30 a.m. to 7:30 a.m. So if I'm gonna do this and make it look good, I'm gonna put a bold here and have it be 4:30 a.m. to 7:30 a.m. Now, if I wanna quickly make this different, what I can do is just showcase, if I put it at 2 in the morning and change this one to make it obvious that this is the one at 2 in the morning, you can see that this is sorting so that the one with the date property that is earlier is going to showcase. So now what I can do is make it so that this is at 7:45 a.m. Change this cover to this yellow one for the growth. to a flex and then change the time from what it's showcasing to 7:45 a.m. to 8 a.m. And then you can have this set to morning, as it is a time of day in the morning. You can set this to morning as a time of day in the morning. And then this is sorting in that way. Now, what you could do instead of having it labeled like this is have the actual time property be in the name and then use this life bucket one to showcase it, as the life buckets can be corresponding. So maybe you would take this and just have the life bucket show instead of the name and have that time property there. It's up to you, but I just wanted to show a few examples of ways that you can have this look for you. Now, when we go into the example that I had made, you'll see that I have all of this labeled out, but then I have a group time blocking section. And this is something that I have been messing around with, where it's essentially a time blocking system that shows morning, afternoon, and evening. So I could have a time block situation where this is not only group by day of the week, but subgroup by time of day, so that it's still sorting by this date ascending for those specific times of day. So the afternoon would only really be my lunch period. It matters on what you consider morning, afternoon, and evening, but this could be something where you just section things off in a different way for yourself. And for if any reason you want to make sure that this is something that would be changing and you want to update this, you could have a this week time block. So if you want to have fun with this and make it something that's consistent, you'd have to filter so that this week question mark is this week. And as everything here is this week, because this is actually this Friday, you'd be fine. But if I say move this task to next week, magically you'll see that it'll disappear. So that's how you can do an example of time blocking in Notion. And you actually can see some other really cool Notion tips if you click on this video right here.